Good morning, students. Today we'll discuss product development. This is the model 3, the PLCM subject. Product development. So what do you mean by product development? It refers to all the activities involved in developing a product or a service right from its initial conceptual stage to its introduction to the market. It may also involve modification of an existing product, like minor changes in design for purpose of improving the technical capabilities. It can be defined as the creation, innovation, continuous improvement of the pre-designed features of an existing product, or developing an entirely new product to satisfy customers' requirements. See, actually the product development, you don't say it is a completely new product, so it may be an existing product, so you can do some minor changes as per the customer satisfaction. So for example, there is a packing cooking oil, the wheat flour and other daily needs in a small quantities. Okay, suppose the customer needs a very small quantity, so that packing will be done in a small pockets. So this is the one of the product development. So there is a minor changes. And I can give one more example, converting landline phones into wireless handsets. Modify an airplane into a fighter jet, it is for the higher speed. Developing electrical automotive vehicles, nowadays it is a very demand, because there is a zero emission, there is a eco-friendly, and one more, traditional library into a e-library. Okay, so what is a new product development? It is now. So it refers all activities from initial conceptual stage to its introduction to the market. A new product opens a whole new market. It can replace the current product, take over an existing product, or broaden the market. It requires an understanding of customer needs and wants, competitive environment and nature of market. So this is what the new product development, how it will change the market, how we can improve your market profitability. Next, so what is the needs for NPD? What are the reasons? So there is a change in the market. The first point, change in the market, change in technology, increasing competition, diversification of risk, reputation and goodwill, utilization of excess capacity, seasonal fluctuation, growth and development. There are some the factors. These are the following factors we'll discuss one by one. Changes in the market. Today, consumer market is a more dynamic compared to the past. So as you know that, it keeps on changing due to varied customer needs. So this is not a unique now, because whatever you want to do, there is a lot of competition. Okay, so with respect to that, so you have to cope up with that. Increase literacy rate, globalized market, heavy competition, and availability of number of substitute products have forced companies to innovate new products. So this is very important point, with this is the very important factor it is. Next, a change in technology. Advancement in science and technology has given a way for development of a new products with a better performance, characteristics and cost when compared to the existing one. Third point, increasing competition. The increased competition between existing companies coupled with the new companies and individual through free enterprise and open markets in one of the primary reasons for new product development. So next, diversification of a risk. Every product will inevitably carry some sort of a risk value. Yes, it is right, it is. The product may not be capable to match with the market needs and wants. A company develops a new product just to diversify risks. Thus, need for continuous innovation arises because older products are thrown out of a market. So this is a very important point, diversification of a risk, because some you want to go for new products, sometimes risk of failure also, but apart from that, you have to take a risk over here. Reputation and goodwill. to create an image and a reputation as an innovative and dynamic company. New products are developed. Okay, if you go on with the same existing product, so you cannot develop your reputation and also you cannot make a goodwill of your company. So for that purpose, so you have to innovate a new product. Utilization of excess capacity. Excess capacity may be in form of production capacity or human skills. To utilize maximum plant and material capacity, the company may opt the development of a new product. Okay, sometimes you have a good infrastructure, you have a number of skilled workers. Okay, to utilize them, so you have to go for the new product. Then there is a one more point, that is a seasonal fluctuation. To meet the product demand due to seasonal fluctuation, new products are developed. Apart from achieving a customer requirements, attractive business can also be maintained in spite of a variation occurring due to the seasonal changes. Growth and development. When it is not possible to accelerate growth rate by existing product, a company prefers to develop a new product to expand its market, maximize sales and earn more profits. Okay, so these are the main factors for the considering the new product. Why you have to go for the new products? So these are the main factors here. Then what are the benefits? The next slide, it says the what are the benefits of a NPD. Helps to stay in tune with the changing customer needs and wants. Helps to retain customer and attract new customers. Maximize sales and earn more profits. Ability to target new markets and increase market share. New products create a new revenue. So these are the main benefits of new product. So next, so there is a building decision support system. This is the DSS. So in the new product development process, decision making at the front end is particularly important as it helps companies concentrate on developing competitive and customer focused products instead of investing in worthless ones. DSS is an interactive information system that uses a communication and technologies, data, knowledge and models to identify and solve problems related to the complete decision making task and make effective decision about various problems. Then what are the characteristics of DSS here? DSS, it is a decision support system. Then what are the characteristics? An ideal decision support system should not be used to make automatic decision. Instead of assist and encourage people in an effective decision making process. Must provide support for both individual and a group of decision makers. Must present information to the customer in a way that is way to understand. A good DSS should be able to respond quickly to the changing needs of decision makers. DSS must be intended to repeated and routine use. What are the advantages? DSS supports both individual and group of decision makers. DSS supports specific capabilities that support one or more tasks related to decision making. DSS helps to improve the accuracy, quality, and overall effectiveness of specific decision. It enables thorough quantitative analysis in a very short time. Data collection and model construction, experimentation are executed with the active use. Then what are the limitations? Even because as you know that there is advantages and disadvantages for this decision supporting system also, there is a limitations beyond that, so you cannot do anything. There is a constraint. The building DSS is often very expensive and complex because people vary so much in terms of their personalities, knowledge and ability, preferences, the jobs they hold and decision they need to make. Because as you know that the human mentality, it is a different, because I can give a different decision, somebody can give a different decision, and everything will be considered here. Sometimes it will be a very expensive and even a complex. DSS provides all information in the form of graphs, pictures and text without much emphasis on the past. A computerized DSS may sometimes result in information overload, which is a major problem for people involved in a decision making. So these are the main limitations of a DSS here. So what are the type of DSS? The type of DSSs are communication driven system, data driven system, document driven system, knowledge driven system, model driven system. So in brief, we'll discuss what are these. The typically the communication driven system relies on a hybrid network and electronic communication technologies to connect decision makers and to create an environment of resources and information sharing, collaboration and communication among a group of decision makers. For example, electronic mails, interactive videos, video conferencing, audio conferencing, file sharing and report boards for paradigms of a group support tools. So this is what how you are going to communicate and how you make a decisions here. So next is a data driven DSS. Data driven DSS enables access to and manipulation of structured data and can handle a time series of internal as well as external company data and real time data. Data driven DSS are separated by functionality. It is generally used to query a database or data warehouses to seek a specific answers for a specific purposes. A data-driven decision support system might make use of database designed for the structure. However, generally it is associated to additional databases. Most data-driven DSSs are targeted at managers, staff and also product service suppliers. It is deployed via main frame systems, client server link or via the web it is. Next, document driven system. Document driven system are more common targeted at a board base of a user groups. The purpose of such DSS is to search web pages and find documentation on a specific set of keywords or search terms. The usual technology used to set up such a DSSs are via the web or the client server system. Examples of documents which may be added into the database comprise guidelines as well as actions, result conditions, brochures and business past data including proceeding of a gathering company accounts, also significant communications. Next, knowledge-driven DSSs. Knowledge-driven DSSs are computer-based reasoning systems with the distinction the artificial intelligence technologies, management expert systems, data mining technologies and communication mechanism are integrated in this. Last one, modeling-driven system. Model-driven DSSs are complex systems that help analyze decisions or choose between different options. These are used by managers and staff of a business or a people who interact with the organizations for a number of purposes depending on how the model is set up, that is a scheduling, decision analysis, etc. The DSS can be deployed via software, hardware in standalone PCs, client server systems or the web. In model-driven system DSS, the choice makers offers partial constraint and information to assist the decision makers to investigate the present circumstances. However, in a common use database is not a preferred for model-driven DSS as compared to other type of a DSS. Okay, so with this, I will conclude We have covered some of the topics from the Model 3. So in the next session, we will cover some more topics from the same model. If you have any clarification, you feel free to contact me. Thank you. Thank you one and all.